Hi folks, Peach Mario here. With the last video, I showed you how to install the Internet Information Service and call it with localhost. Now we'll have a closer look with the ISS manager and activate WebDAV and all the other stuff that's needed to save TillyWiki. So first of all, we change the view to category. It gives us a little bit better overview. And then we have the site directory. So this is what we saw with localhost. Everything is created automatically when you install the stuff as shown in the last video. Okay, the default document is defined here. So if, because we had this ISS start HTML is what we can see here. Okay. Now what do we need to work with TillyWiki and WebDAV? We need to enable WebDAV. Okay, say double click. It says the WebDAV feature has been disabled. Now enable it. And this is really very, very important. Don't forget this. It cost me already some hours. So select the default web page or the default site. Double click WebDAV and activate it, enable it. What we need here is some authoring rules, so which defines which users are able to read and write the stuff. We say all content, all users can read and write the stuff. All users now here means every user which is configured with this PC. So if you have a role-based settings, you can say admin or guests or editors or whatever. Or in this case, my user would be PMario. So then only this user has access. I say all users and this is basically the same with PMario. The important part here is this is the writing adjustments, and with I think ISS 7 WebDAV can only write if you are authenticated. So this is important. With with lower versions it may be possible to write anonymous as a guest, but it's not possible anymore. So that's why we disable anonymous and we enable basic authentication. There is a warning which says SSL is not defined. With the local setting, this is not a problem. If you have internet access or if you want to access your pages from the internet, then you have to have SSL enabled. So first, enable WebDAV and then enable authentication. What's next? We need a virtual directory. It's called virtual directory. We add one, which will be then accessible with localhost slash TillyWiki slash index or slash empty, and it needs a physical path. So to store the documents, we don't have any yet, so we need to create it. We create a new path. I use users public and documents public. And I create a new folder with right click, new folder, TillyWiki. So which will be C users, public documents, TillyWiki. To get better access, I can say include it into the documents library. Now it activates libraries, documents, TillyWiki. So I get a little bit faster access. Okay, so we have it, say physical path, libraries, documents, TillyWiki. Okay, so now we have the documents, we have authentication. Now we need some documents. So we download, we go to TillyWiki. com and we download empty, save file, every download full, save file. Okay. Open the path, index empty, cut. I cut it. There is my others, public documents. Right click, paste. So now I pasted it to say users public TillyWiki. Now we have two files there. Now let's have a look if we can access them. TillyWiki index.html. Yeah, because we have basic authentication activated, we need a username. Mario. And I can activate it. That's right. Save it for the next time. Okay, now we have index.html and we have empty.html. Okay, right. So create a new tilde, say save, and it says save it. That's right. So reload, recent. Utility. That's cool. Yeah. So now we have the possibility to write empty and also index. Reload. Utility. Yeah. With the manager, there are different views. We have the first view is the features view, and now we also have the content view. Yeah. So for example, if I say right click index.html, I can change the permissions, edit permissions, read only. Say okay. If I say save now, it gives me an error. There is a little bit to do with TillyWiki, so we need to have better error messages because this is now forbidden. And there is the red screen of death, so which we should avoid in the future. Yeah? So this is a little bit nasty at the moment, but should be no real problem. Yeah? So I just activated it that way so that you know it. If there is an error message, not much happens. It may be the right permissions. Okay, what did we do? We defined the webdav, the authoring rules, so every user which is part of the PC can read and write. We defined the authentication for basic authentication. We did create a virtual directory. In this case, it's the TillyWiki directory. If I say, where can I see the path? Ah, okay, here there is an alias name which is called, which is used here, localhost TillyWiki, and it needs a physical path. We copied, we downloaded empty and index.html and we copied it to this directory. Yeah, that's basically it. With the next video, I will give you an overview of some problems or some issues that can arise. And yeah, have fun.